My name is Naveen Reddy. In this video lecture, I would like to discuss registration under GST. There is no concept of centralized registration as in service tax. So separate registration has to be obtained in each state or union territory. First, I will explain the summary of the chapter. Registration is covered under section number 22 to section number 30 of the CGST Act. Section number 22. Persons liable for registration. If the aggregate turnover of a person exceeds 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs in a special category states, except Jammu and Kashmir. So in Jammu and Kashmir, 20 lakhs is applicable. And point number 2. Already registered under the existing laws. If a person is already registered under the existing laws like VAT, service tax or central excise, then he has to register under GST. Point number 3. Transfer. In case of transfer, transferee has to take registration, and in case of amalgamation or demerger, transferee has to obtain registration. And section number 23. Persons not liable for registration. 1. Person making exclusively non-taxable supplies or wholly exempt supplies. And 2. Agriculturist only to the extent of produce of cultivation of land. So if an agriculturist is making supplies other than cultivation of land and such supplies exceeds 20 lakhs, then he has to take registration. 3. Notified persons. And section number 24. Section number 22 is saying persons liable for registration. And section number 24 is saying compulsory registration. That is, these persons are liable to be registered irrespective of this 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs. 1. Interstate supplies. 2. Casual taxable person. 3. Recipient who is liable to pay tax under reverse charge mechanism. 4. E-commerce operator. 5. Non-resident taxable person. Point number 6. Person who is required to deduct TDS under section number 51. TDS is covered under section number 51 and TCS is covered under section number 52. Agent. An agent who makes taxable supplies on behalf of a principal. And input service distributor. Person who is required to collect TCS under section number 52. And IDAR services, that is online information and database access and retrieval services. Section number 25. Procedure for registration. If a person is liable for registration under section number 22 or section number 24, then within 30 days from the date when he is liable to get registered, he has to apply in form REG1. Then registration certificate will be granted within 3 working days, or he will give a show cause notice in REG3. Then the taxable person has to reply in REG4 within 7 working days from the date of receipt of show cause notice. If the taxable person not replied within 7 working days, then he will reject the application by passing an order in REG5. Or if the taxable person replies within 7 working days, then he will approve within 7 working days from the date of receipt of clarification in REG4. PAN is compulsory for registration and TAN is also compulsory. He is required to deduct TDS. Section number 26. Deemed registration. If proper officer not taken action within 3 working days or 7 working days, then the person is deemed to be registered. 3 working days or 7 working days. And section number 27. Registration of casual taxable person or non-resident taxable person. They have to apply for registration 5 days before the commencement of the business. Others have to apply within 30 days from the date when they are liable to get registered. So this is before 5 days and that is after 30 days. Validity. Such registration certificate will be valid for a period of 90 days or a period mentioned in the application for registration. So whichever is earlier. So it will be valid for a maximum period of 90 days. Such period can be extended for further 90 days. So 90 plus 90. So it can be valid for a maximum period of 180 days. At the time of registration, the non-resident taxable person has to make advance deposit of expected liability and it will be credited in the e-cash ledger. And he has to make additional deposit of expected liability if the registration is further extended. And section number 28. Amendment of registration. If you want amendment of registration, he has to make application in REG 14 within 15 days from the date of such change. And it will be approved within 15 working days in REG number 15. Or else he will issue a show cause notice in REG 3. Then we have to reply within 7 working days in REG number 4. Section number 29, cancellation of registration. Registration may be cancelled on suo motu or on the application of the supplier. We can make application in the following 3 cases. 1. Discontinuation of business, that is death of proprietor or amalgamation or demerger. And 2. Change in the constitution of business. 3. No longer liable. If a person who has taken voluntary registration is no longer liable, then he can make application under REG 16 for cancellation of registration on suo motu basis. If a person has contravened any of the provisions of the GST Act or rules made there under, the registration will be cancelled. Composition scheme for 3 consecutive tax periods. If a person who has opted composition scheme has not filed returns for 3 consecutive tax periods, then the registration will be cancelled. He is not saying months, he is saying 3 consecutive tax periods. And other registered person who has not filed returns for a continuous period of 6 months. Here he is saying tax periods and here he is saying months, 6 months. And a person who has taken voluntary registration has not commenced the business for a period of 6 months. How the department will know? For example, if you are filing nil returns for 6 months, then the department will know that you haven't commenced the business. Fraud. If the registration is obtained by fraud, then he will cancel the registration on suo motu basis. If the registration is cancelled, the liability will not get affected. So you have to pay all the pending liabilities as on the date of cancellation of registration. Section number 30. Revocation of cancellation of registration. That is, if the registration is cancelled, how to restore it and how to get back the cancelled registration. You have to make application in REG number 21 within 30 days from the date of cancellation. Then he will approve in REG number 22, or he will issue a show cause notice in REG 23. Then taxable person has to reply in REG 24 within 7 working days from the date of receipt of show cause notice. Then within 30 days from the date of receipt of REG 24, he will dispose of the application. This is the summary of the chapter. I am also posting it in my Facebook. If you understand the summary of the chapter, it will be very easy to understand the rest of the chapter. So please note down this or take a snapshot of this.